Hello children, and welcome to the video tutorial. In this video today, we will do English Literature Standard 5, Lesson 4, The Hero of Harlem. The story is written by Mary Mapes Dodge. Harlem is a city in Netherlands. Netherlands means land which is lower than the level of the sea. And this Harlem city is in Netherlands. So, people who are living in this place, Harlem, they need to build dikes. Dikes is a great thick wall as wide as roads. Now you can see here, the sea level is here and the ground level here is low. So, the people who live here near this place, they need to make these dikes to prevent this water from rushing inside the city and washing it away. So in this story, we will learn about a boy named Hans, how he saved the city and what he did. So many years ago, there was a boy named Hans who lived in Harlem. He was a very kind boy. His father was in charge of the dikes, means his father used to take care of these dikes, maintenance and all those things. One day his father had gone to town for some work, and it was a holiday for Harlem. So during the holidays, Hans used to go with his father and used to observe his father, what his father was doing in the dikes. So that day his father was not in town, he had gone somewhere else. So he was feeling bored at home. So his mother said, "Son, I'll prepare some bread and few cakes. You go and give it to Uncle Johnson." He happily agreed, "Okay, Mom." Mr. Johnson was an old man who was living alone and he could not see properly now. And he was living with his dog whose name was Alphonse. He was living near the dikes. So when mother said that I'll prepare some bread and bake some cakes for the uncle, he was very happy. Why he was happy? Because uncle was staying alone, and whenever Hans used to visit Uncle Jansen, Uncle Jansen used to tell him of the stories of the past, how the things were in the past. Uncle enjoyed telling him, and Hans also loved listening to uncle. So when his mother said that you have to go take this bread and cakes to uncle, he was very happy. So his mother handed over the basket and told him, "Son, you take this to uncle and make sure you come back by 6 o'clock, because by 6 o'clock we will have dinner." He said, "Okay, Mom, I won't be late." And he left. That day it was raining. It was raining very hard. It was raining very hard, it was pelting. And Hans was walking in the rain. He had his raincoat covering his body. He was walking and he was feeling a little cold also because of the wind and the rain. So somehow he reached uncle's house. When he entered the house, uncle found that he was wet. So he told him to sit down, take rest. And Hans handed over the basket of bread and cakes to uncle, and they started talking. Whenever these two they met, they used to talk a lot. They used to enjoy each other's company. And they were talking. Suddenly Hans looked at the watch and realized that he was late. It was already past 6. So he said, "Oh, I'm so late. I won't be able to reach home. My mother must be waiting for the dinner." So he said thank you and bye to uncle, and he started back his journey towards his home. Now, since it was raining regularly, it was pouring down hard, it was pelting, it was wind all over the place, the rain had not reduced, he started his backward journey. Now, when he was walking back, he was wearing a wooden shoe which was getting stuck on the muddy brick road. He was finding it difficult to walk. See, so he still managed, he was walking, he was feeling very cold. Since he was feeling very cold, he was thinking of a cozy bed and a warm dinner waiting at home. While he was walking, he was wondering also, if something goes wrong to this dikes now, who will take care of this, since my father is away? And suddenly he spotted something. He spotted that there was a small hole in between two stones and the water was trickling. Water was seeping. So he went close and he had a look and he found that it was not threatening. The hole was very small. But he realized that since it is raining so heavily and it has been raining since long, and the water from the other side might push more pressure and make this hole a bigger hole, and which will cause a havoc in the city. It might rust inside the city and wash the city. So, without wasting much time, he shouted for help. But since it was raining and wind was blowing very hard, no one could hear him. So he thought that now I will have to do something. So he put his fist inside the hole. Now when he put his fist inside the hole, the water stopped seeping. There was no seepage now. Water was not coming this side, water was at that side, or other side of the dike. He was waiting there. Suddenly he turned and he found that his uncle Jensen was behind him. Then uncle was in shock. He asked, "What are you doing here?" Then he explained to uncle. "Uncle, when I was coming back from your house, I noticed this and I have put my fist inside. I shouted for help but no one heard because of rain and wind." So uncle said, "Okay, wait." Now uncle went back and he called a group of people. He informed them that there is a crack or there is a damage in the dike and we need to repair. So he called a group of people. They all came, and at that time Hans removed his fist, and those people they repaired the dike. Then uncle told Hans, "My son, now first you come to my house," because he was wet and he was tired. So uncle first took him back to his house, made him sit there. He gave him something warm to drink, and he told him, "Son, I'm proud of you. You have saved this town. You have saved this dike. Now, tomorrow morning, I will go and tell the people the story of a brave boy who saved this town." So, this is the story of Hans, the hero of Haarlem. We have sent you the study material also. Please go through the study materials, copy them in your copy, and go through the chapter once again yourself and try to understand what meanings are given at the bottom. And I have also mentioned few word meanings here. So please write down these study materials in the class of copy. That's all for this video, children. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.